This is the practice in the channel grant and also practice of the channel grant. I thought we're going to start with a little bit of channel grant meditation. So the concept or idea of channel grant is immensely important, significant. Many of you have been practicing Cho. Some are new to this practice. So I just thought we're going to cultivate some beginner's mind together and see if we can go through all different levels of channel ground. First, we identify, then connect in ourselves, how we respond to that, and then how we can deal with that, how we can rest in that channel ground. So channel ground is, I call the dojo practice place or the setting for practitioners, tantric practitioners like us. So in other words, without going through a channel ground, no transformation will happen. It's messy. At the same time, it's a place for transformation, place for insight, liberation, freedom. See if all of us can cultivate the willingness to go there, at least to get in touch with how the channel grounds feels like each of us through this short meditation. I'm going to guide ourselves into. All right. Nothing special again, but it's important to bring awareness to that, whatsoever happening outside, inside, in our body, and the deepest channel ground. So that's what we're going to do. So as usual, take a moment to pause. See if you can bring entirety of your being, not just a part of your being, like a holy part of yourself, peaceful part of yourself. Just show up, just as you are, whatever happening in your life, globally, in your personal level. The first, so we are living in the external channel ground. What does that mean to you? Take a look at that. Whatever is happening, these polarities, fights, arguments, taking a position, all are based on ideas. We fight over race, gender, opinions, whatever it might be. See if we can get in touch with how we live in this external channel ground. We all sentient beings are affected by this, right? Without ignoring or without backing off, if you really dive into this dojo for practitioners, just as a human citizen, connect to this melting pot of confusion, chaos. And also, if you can really see the wisdom or insight in that channel ground, freedom, release, liberation, possibility of awakening in this exact same channel ground. See if you can even have a sense or smell or a guts feeling of this is a place where transformation or awakening is happening. So in that sense, what your relation to this channel ground or outer or external channel ground? What's your approach? What's your attitude? What's your relationship? Now look at your own internal channel ground, the body. Whenever we say the internal, something to do with the body, which is conditioned with its pains and vulnerabilities to any disease, virus, changing from moment to moment, aging moment to moment. It eventually decays and becomes compost back to the earth, recycled. How much attachment do you have to this physical body, which is so ephemeral? What's your relationship to this internal channel ground? Are you trying to make impermanence things permanent? Can you find freedom in this channel ground by releasing attachment to changing phenomena? And now, your subtle body. See if it can go a little deeper and bring your attention to the lower gate, the end tip of the central channel at the perineum, the most, you can say, primitive part of the chakra system. First, can you feel the channel ground in there? How does it feel like? Dark, the fear, instinctual fear for survival, fear of a self separated from our human tribe. See if we can feel into that chakra or the internal subtle body which holds the channel ground of fear. Make sure you use a breath and gentle awareness. Feel into the second chakra, lower belly, this degree of unmet need, unacknowledged emotions, unfulfilled fantasies and longings. In other words, disowned part of yourself, all are in there. It's like a lake. I like to imagine that way. Debris coming up on the surface of the lake in the lower belly. See if you can connect to that channel ground. Are you even willing to take a look at that? This is a chance. This is an opportunity. See if you can rest in that experience. Tantra talks about all these debris, gods and demons, yucky part of ourselves, all our wisdom in disguise, struggle to reject our suffering and confusion, but we can awaken to the wisdom inherent in painful experiences. See if we can acknowledge our true essence as Prajna Paramita, just as we practice in Chö practice. See if we can really approach that which we usually don't want to approach. Here, metaphorically speaking, channel ground that scares us. Invite, welcome, and get in touch with our gods and demons. So that's the essence of Chö practice, you can say. One way to say it. The key to have an embodied experience, it's crucial you bring your body, you invite your body to this meditation practice. Connect your breath, energy, and go through the somatic process as well. So now take a moment to breathe into and bring awareness to your wherever, your body, that channel ground which you didn't like to deal with, show up. So now specifically, I want you to imagine, remember, get in touch with something recently happened or a long time ago happened, something you feel aversion or you feel regrettable, yucky feeling. Do you know what I'm talking about? It's perhaps guilt or shame or something. Make it specific. Bring it up. You can say just like a debris of the lake. Bring it to the surface of the lake. And now I want you to imagine or visualize yourself standing in front of you. That the one who made a mistake and made you feel regret. A sense of honest remorse. In other words, it's part of you manifested in front of you. You're facing yourself. Now I want you to breathe into that feeling of yours, into your heart, if you like. Or entire body. Connect or invite to the spaciousness of your whole being. You can breathe into the heart center, or if you like, you can breathe into the entire body. That the feeling you found in the channel ground. Just connect to the feeling, fear manifesting, perhaps as a guilt or shame, whatever it may be, a yucky feeling. Then exhale and see if you can allow it to dissolve into the large expanse of space of open heart, spaciousness, like the sky. Breathe into one big sky and then let it feel dissolve. Magic said, like the sky without hopes and fears. Relax without indulging hopes and fears. Like the sky, without clinging to self, do not cling to the self, giving up attachment. Something like that. See if we can do this. Charnel, breathe in, breathe out. Perhaps sending out forgiveness, kindness, a sense of release and relaxation. Inhale, connect to the sense of whatever you've done and the regret. Touch that feeling, invite the feeling, and also what's around that feeling, the suffering involved, the pain you feel, a sense of forever I'm doomed kind of feeling. Connect with the energy. How does that feel? Energy in your body. Did you notice? That's just the energy, open, unobstructed energy. Initially very strong energy with some kind of flavor, judgment. See if you can just rest just as it is. Even you don't need to transform it into wisdom. It is wisdom. It's your awareness, open awareness, a sense of spaciousness. In whatever way you might like to feel or letting go, dissolving back to true nature. I want you to be in that blue sky of your awareness. Immerse yourself in this experience for a few moments. Rest. And just a short dedication or just short practice, meditation. Whatever goodness comes from my practice, our meditation, our experience, bring us to authentic self or benefit or the actualization of who and what we truly are.